mentioned that you can do 14 different activities at a given moment. So we all are very curious to know, how can we achieve such prowess over both body and mind?
Oh, whoever said this, I didn't say anything like that. Anyway, do you have a liver?
Yes, I do.
Functioning?
Yes.
Do you know how many levels of activity it's doing right now? What the liver is doing is far more complex than what your brains are doing right now, do you know this? A brainless liver, if it can do so many things, a brain praneet, how many things? No, I was only talking about not activity per se. Yes, activity is also possible. So you must understand this. On a round planet which is spinning right now, hello? Are you on a round planet? Spinning? Most people don't understand this unless, you know, they get sozzled out with something or they get some ailment. Suddenly you see, planet is round. Do you know how complex an activity it is for a human being to walk at a certain latitude on a round planet which is spinning and which has magnetic forces working upon you all the time? It's an extremely complex process. You ask a child who is, let's say, 1 year of age, he knows how complex it is. Have you seen? But the moment you learn to walk, you assume that it's nothing, walking is nothing, and you're sick of walking, you want to drive a car, you want to ride a motorcycle. But walking is such a complex process, not 14. 1,000 different functions, your knees and your brains and the fluids in your body, all of them are doing all the time. If only you could conduct these things consciously, you would be doing 1,000 things. Anyway, you're doing it. But if you could conduct this consciously, you would do 1,000 things at a time. So I was only talking about different channels of mind, which you don't have to actually conduct, you just have to initiate and leave. It will go on. For you to think about your neighborhood girl, do you have to initiate action every time? No. Once you look at her, it just goes on by itself. Why? Because you're drawn to it. If you're drawn to 10 different things at the same time, mind is capable of creating 10 different channels and keep it running. A complex mathematical problem, a sensation, a music, some raga, this, that, 100 things at the same time, because that is how complex human mind is. This complexity you can use either to drive yourself crazy with unbridled thought and emotion, or if you harness it, it can do things that nobody has imagined possible. It can do things in a miraculous way. You can manifest things in a phenomenal way if the necessary training goes. If somebody is walking there, if you just look at them, how they are walking, you can make out whether they are physically fit or not. Yes or no? Body has been worked upon, you can see it or no, just by the walk. Similarly, whether the mind has been worked upon or not, whether your energies have been worked upon or not, is something that's visible. Most people may not see, but if you pay attention, you will see. Right now, most human beings, the problem is, we gave you a super, super, super computer. The most sophisticated machine on this planet is this human mechanism. I am asking you, have you read the user's manual? Hello? No. When are you going to read it? On the last day? When I see this ridiculous stuff, people reading Gita when people are dying, I say, you're reading the user's manual on the last day, what's the point? If you buy a phone, should you read the user's manual in the first 3 days or after 3 years when you want to get rid of the phone? Huh? You must read it in the first 3 days. So I'm not asking you to read a scripture. Well, this is a living scripture. Should you not become competent to read the scripture? Understand what is the nature of this, what is the full potential of it, and explore this? Because this life is not about this or that. This life is about this. There is no choice about this. It is just that you can enslave this life to something else and think it's about that. But actually it's about this. Are you okay with this? You think right now your life is about education. No, your life is about this. You want this one educated. You want this one to do well. You want this one to experience love. You want this one to experience pleasure. You want this one to do all this. All the other things are only attendant things. This is the real thing, isn't it? So if this is the real thing, does this deserve some amount of attention? Some amount of attention means not standing in front of the mirror and attending to your skin endlessly. Should you not pay attention to every dimension of what this human being is made of? What makes this life tick? And how? If you understand what makes it tick, you can make it roar. If you make it roar, why 14 things you can do many more?